The race for lunar exploration is heating up. SpaceX has revealed the launch schedule for its first Starship launch, which took off from Florida, a major milestone that paves the way for future lunar expeditions. In a significant development, Blue Origin has launched an ambitious initiative aimed at launching an uncrewed Blue Moon Propellant Transport mission. The project is intended to provide critical refueling support for its lunar lander as it orbits the Moon. Preparations for the upcoming crude oil landing are currently underway. When is SpaceX's next launch scheduled? What are the implications of Blue Origin's latest mission? Plus, how does this initiative impact the future of lunar exploration? Let's talk more on today's episode of NR Studio. As we reach the halfway point of 2025, uncertainty remains about the readiness of NASA contractors SpaceX and Blue Origin for their Artemis program responsibilities. In a significant move, both companies have recently embarked on bold initiatives that have the potential to instill new confidence across the aerospace sector. Let's start with SpaceX. In an update released on March 3, 2025, titled The Future of Starship Development, SpaceX revealed that it was nearing completion of its environmental review. The company plans to launch the inaugural SpaceX Starship from Launch Complex 39A in Florida, with a target date of late 2025 for the milestone event. At first glance, this proposed schedule may seem quite ambitious, perhaps even overly optimistic. SpaceX has not yet completed the development of its launch pad infrastructure in Florida, and there is still significant progress needed to fully master the Starship launch system. The concept of launching Starship from LC-39A has been under consideration for some time. In 2022, SpaceX successfully completed assembly of the launch tower at Launch Complex 39A, LC-39A. In 202, an environmental impact statement was released, detailing plans to facilitate as many Starship launches each year from Florida. If SpaceX successfully launches from Florida later this year, it would be a major milestone in preparation for the Artemis 3 mission, which is scheduled for mid-2027. It would give the company about 18 months to conduct an uncrewed Starship HLS test mission and develop an orbital refueling system. SpaceX undoubtedly has a long list of goals to accomplish in order to realize this vision. To start the launch framework, SpaceX is actively preparing to launch Starship from a pair of launch pads located in Florida, specifically LC-39A and SLC-37. Currently, LC-39A stands out as the frontrunner, having made significant progress thus far. Construction of the orbital launch pad and flame trench has begun, with the launch tower already in place. These structures are designed based on the specifications of the B launch pad used on Starbase. However, the timeline will be limited. Construction efforts on Starbase's bomb pad and flame trench began in late 2023, with fundamental structural work slated to be completed by early May 2025. To achieve the desired goals, it may be necessary to accelerate the pace of construction in Florida. It is set to launch by the end of the year. Fortunately, SpaceX has gained valuable insights from its operations at Starbase, which will help facilitate a more efficient construction process in Florida. In terms of production capabilities, SpaceX has revealed plans for a significant new facility, dubbed Gigabay, which will be built adjacent to the current X hangar, commonly referred to as the Roberts Road facility, located at NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida. The impressive structure will reach a height of 380 feet, about 115.8 meters, and will feature more than 6.5 million cubic feet, about 1.3 million cubic meters, of usable interior space. The interior will include more than 815,000 square feet, which is more than 75,000 square meters of operational space. Gigabay, Florida will enhance the integration, repair, and production processes for Starship and Super Heavy V3. The facility will feature the ability to manage as many as 2 workstations operating simultaneously. In terms of capacity, those numbers are truly impressive. Gigabay is set to provide significantly enhanced capabilities with 11 times the work area, 19 additional work bays, and twice the lifting capacity when compared to Megabay at Starbase. SpaceX currently boasts its most advanced vertical integration facility. Preparations for the Gigabay project are currently underway, as site work has already begun. However, full construction is expected to be completed by 2026. In the meantime, early Starship models destined for missions in Florida will continue to be built at Starbase in Texas before being transported to Florida via barge. In short, the coming months are set to be a turning point for SpaceX Florida expansion efforts. The company is aiming to conduct its first Starship launch from the East Coast before the start of 2026, a significant step in establishing a reliable, high-frequency launch facility. If accomplished, this endeavor could open the door to anticipated launches every year, demonstrating SpaceX's ability to meet the demands of the Artemis mission. What are your thoughts on the matter? Do you believe SpaceX is on track to conduct its first Starship flight from Florida before the end of the year? Share your thoughts, yes or no, in the comments section below. Be sure to like the video and subscribe to our channel to stay updated on SpaceX's exciting journey to the moon and beyond. In addition to SpaceX, its main competitor and partner in NASA Human Landing System program, Blue Origin has recently made some significant and somewhat unexpected progress. Notoriously secretive about its progress, the company has recently begun to reveal more details about its lunar exploration aspirations, shedding light on a timeline that has previously remained shrouded in mystery. Following its successful acquisition of a $3.0 billion NASA contract, Blue Origin recently unveiled its lunar lander, dubbed Blue Moon. While the lander announcement was significant, the real breakthrough came with the recent reveal of a critical element that could determine the mission's long-term success, the transporter vehicle. In a recent presentation at the Lunar Surface Innovation Consortium on May 19th, John Couras, Blue Origin's Senior Vice President of Lunar Performance, revealed a conceptual rendering of the transporter. The innovative vehicle is designed to refuel the Blue Moon Mark II crewed lander while orbiting the moon. He outlined that the vehicle has made significant progress since the initial contract award. The illustration shows a T-shaped configuration featuring a relatively elongated cylindrical body. One end appears to be specifically designed for compatibility with the lander, likely featuring a fuel pumping mechanism. The propulsion system is likely located at the opposite end of the structure from the control system. This arrangement suggests that the fuel will be supplied via a direct transfer mechanism, similar to SpaceX's method for refueling its Starship. In this innovative approach, a tanker is launched to dock with the spacecraft and transfer fuel directly. However, Blue Origin's strategy goes further. Rather than conducting a refueling operation in Earth orbit, the company aims to conduct a fuel transfer in lunar orbit, a far more complex and ambitious undertaking. The transporter will initially ascend to Earth orbit, where it will collect propellant. This propellant will consist of liquid hydrogen and liquid oxygen sourced from excess fuel left over from the upper stage of its launch vehicle, known as New Glenn. The propellant is set to be housed in tanks located inside the transporter, with each tank measuring about 7 meters, 23 feet, in diameter. To ensure the fuel's usefulness throughout the mission, Blue Origin is implementing zero boil-off technology. This innovative system is designed to keep cryogenic propellant in a liquid state by maintaining extremely low temperatures. Specifically, the storage temperature for liquid hydrogen will be maintained at about 20 Kelvin, which is equivalent to minus 253 degrees C. Meanwhile, liquid oxygen will be maintained at about 90 Kelvin, which is equivalent to minus 183 degrees C. Once the fuel aggregation process is complete in Earth orbit, the transporter will begin its journey to a nearly rectilinear halo orbit around the moon. Upon arrival, the transporter will remain in position to rendezvous with the Blue Lunar Lander, facilitating the transfer of critical propellant required for its descent and return mission. This approach allows the lander to conserve its entire fuel supply for the critical phases of lunar landing, exploration, and ascent back to lunar orbit, rather than exhausting it during the journey from Earth. Colorus has announced that the newly developed transporter will have the capacity to transport as much as 100 metric tons of propellant from Earth orbit to lunar orbit. Interestingly, with a few minor changes, most notably to the communication system, the existing vehicle design has the capability to transport as much as 30 metric tons to Mars orbit. Caris highlighted the broader significance of this groundbreaking development, suggesting it could pave the way for access to the asteroid belt and perhaps even the wider solar system. He emphasized that gaining expertise in long-term storage of cryogenic fuels such as liquid hydrogen and liquid oxygen is a significant advancement in propulsion technology. This development is set to improve performance and provide greater flexibility for missions beyond the moon. This capability also aligns with the goal of harnessing resources extracted from other celestial bodies, such as water ice, which can be converted into viable fuels for future missions. Blue Origin and NASA have made significant strides in integrating an early prototype of their fuel transport system. Testing has already begun, starting with assessments conducted in a thermal vacuum chamber. In June, they aim to demonstrate the system's capacity to consistently maintain cryogenic fuels at a steady state. By the end of the year, the company plans to begin production of operational flight units, laying a solid foundation for future critical missions. This includes a series of efforts starting with an unprecedented test landing mission using the Blue Moon Mark II, followed by a crewed lunar landing anticipated before the end of the decade. Before reaching the milestone, Blue Origin is gearing up for the launch of its initial lander model, the Blue Moon Mark I, which is scheduled to take place as early as this year. This iteration is roughly the same diameter as the Apollo lunar module, but has a much higher height. However, it is still about half the height of the Mark II. The Mark I lander is designed to carry as much as 3 metric tons of cargo to the lunar surface. The upcoming mission is set to carry a camera payload as part of NASA Commercial Lunar Payload Services program. The lunar lander is currently under assembly at Blue Origin's Florida facility. It is expected to be ready to leave the factory in about 6 weeks. The spacecraft will then be transported to NASA Johnson Space Center, where it will undergo thermal vacuum testing. After completing this testing, the spacecraft will be returned to Florida in preparation for launch. The spacecraft will begin a 7-day journey to the moon, launched aboard a New Glenn rocket. In parallel with this ongoing effort, Blue Origin is in the process of developing a second Blue Moon Mark I lander, which will replace the inaugural mission. This move reflects the company's increasing dedication to maintaining a consistent lunar operation schedule. With this progress, Blue Origin is clearly transitioning from conceptual designs to concrete progress. The company is poised to establish itself not only as a competitor in the aerospace sector, but also as a key player in humanity's return to the moon and future exploration beyond. Blue Origin has made significant progress in its preparations for the upcoming crewed lunar mission. In partnership with NASA, the company recently conducted an underwater simulation at the Neutral Buoyancy Laboratory, located inside NASA Johnson Space Center. The facility, designed to simulate the weightlessness found in space, created an authentic environment to evaluate astronauts' performance on the moon. During the evaluation, divers donned special spacesuits and added extra weights to mimic the lunar gravity. The participants engaged in a variety of submerged activities to mimic the movements and operations that astronauts would perform on the lunar surface. One of the primary goals of the exercise was to conduct an evaluation using a full-scale replica of the Blue Moon Mark II lander. The extravehicular activity, AEVA exercise, involved a series of exercises designed to evaluate the methods astronauts would use to safely enter and exit the lunar lander. It also assessed how they would engage with various equipment and manage cargo transportation on the lunar surface. Blue Origin emphasized that the mock-up closely approximated the actual dimensions of the lander's airlock, emphasizing its proximity to the lunar surface. Over the course of 2 days, the team assessed several critical systems critical to the mission. In the latest announcement, the companies emphasized, "We have demonstrated our ability to transport astronauts and cargo to the lunar surface while ensuring the crew returns safely in the event of an emergency." In short, both SpaceX and Blue Origin are making significant progress as they reach more tangible milestones in their respective journeys to the moon. Given the current progress, there is every reason to feel hopeful that the United States will reclaim its position as a leader in space exploration, regardless of the intensity of the competition it may face. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next episode, and thank you all for your support.